Travis came out, looks like he put on quite a bit of weight from last night. I know he put on about 15. He was smiling and smirking. He's a great fighter, but I think his underestimation of me is definitely what lost him the fight. He came out thinking I was going to be really tentative, and I came out just kind of tried to feel him out, and I saw him chopping at my legs. You know, I got no feeling in my shins. You can chop on those things all day. And I saw him putting his hands down every time he threw that leg kick. So I let him hit me once, let him hit me twice, backed up, stepped back in because I thought he was swinging again. As soon as I saw his hands drop and his legs start to come around, I just stepped in with an overhand right. You know what I mean? I'll eat a leg kick if I can hit someone on the chin any day, for sure.
After you hit him with the shot, did you know that pretty much the fight was over?
No. I thought he would recover. He went down like a ton of bricks, made a big bang. And I caught him on his back, and he started to push off. So I caught him again behind the ear. Probably knocked his equilibrium off a bit. Then he went limp, and I hit him 3 or 4 more times because I knew the ref was right behind me. Unfortunately, I accidentally hit the ref in the process. I'm sorry to the ref. But
yeah, I was talking to the ref. He said that you actually punched him in the face.
Yeah, I guess I punched him. I was too excited, you know what I mean? I wanted to make sure Travis was out and dead. I know how much of a dangerous guy he is. So I wanted to make sure he was dead. I mistook the ref for him. It happens.
So if the ref asked for a shot at your title, you going to give it to him?
We already had discussed that. He's going to meet me behind the foundry.
Yeah.
Later after I've had a few drinks. I don't think he's going to show, but, you know, I don't know. I'll be there with the bell if he wants to fight.
Not too many people gave you a shot. You were the heavy, heavy underdog in this fight. Were you confident coming into the fight?
I was not nervous whatsoever, you know what I mean? I've watched a lot of Travis Galvis tapes. You know, I like being the underdog because, well, I'm in the gym and, you know, I'm done my work and my body's screaming and saying, no more, no more. I'm saying, screw that, do it again because I know that Travis is doing 10 more reps, so I'm going to do 10 more reps. You know, he's doing 20, I'm going to do 25. Being the underdog, it was great, and it was also great having this fight in my hometown. I totally fed off the crowd, the fans. It was amazing.
The crowd went wild. It was a great fight. I think that coming into the fight, no one gave you a chance, but your team was telling me that you were very, very prepared, ready to go. Was it something that you fed off of, the energy in the crowd?
I totally fed off the energy in the crowd. They just kept me going, my team in the back, you know, watching my other competitors fight, my boys. It got me pumped. It got me jacked. And, you know, once I stepped into the cage and the door locked, I didn't feel like an underdog anymore. I felt like an equal.
Parting thoughts?
Any parting thoughts? Nope. Just get back in the gym on Monday, train harder, get ready to defend this belt on whoever's next in line.
Congratulations on your fight. That's Nick Hinchliffe, new light heavyweight King of the Cage champion. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.